Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the following recording goes back to September. It will go back to September the 8th of 2020. We are talking about exactly, let me see this here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's this recording right here. 945. It is. You're about to hear me conversing with a gentleman. A Roman gentleman. This is a member of Czech Roma community. By the way, I would like to thank Roma communities on both sides of the border, that is in a Czech Republic and in Poland, especially to the Roma people, because they have accepted me. In a real picture, after the MKUltra ordeal, which was not only ordeal for me, this MKUltra damaged, even ruined in some cases, lives of Roma people. It was very, very bad stuff that went on. And the way they have accepted me in real time was simply, it was exceptional. I rate this exceptional. I would like to express gratitude at this opportunity. I am going to go ahead, I'm going to play you the audio recording, give you what I have to state in respect to the audio recording, then I'm going to give you a complete background on how this audio recording even happened, what I have gone through that day, where I was, and so on. And then what I will do is I am going to play you again basically entire tape, which is about 25 minutes, just to for you to see the relationship between me and this Roma gentleman. It was not the only one like this. I have to say my relationship with Roma people on both sides of the border was exceptionally good. They have accepted me, and they were not cheap with the time, and if they only could help and make me feel good. This gentleman was the gentleman eventually that was so concerned for me when in Ostrava. He was gonna pay me eventually for a bus ticket to Poland. I will tell more about it once I go through this thing. But first, what I want to do is I want to present the proofs. Then I'm going to tell you more about how I got here and about him. And in the end, you get to hear the whole tape, nothing but a tape. That's all. Basically, that's how I plan on doing this stuff here. This is supposed to be used for investigation purposes. September 8, 2020, in this audio recording at specified location, this bridge built sometimes in 2012, 2013, if I zoom myself completely out of the picture to demonstrate you where Ostrava is, but it's a lot of these red dots, that's where Ostrava is, and this is the border where I was at the time. So I would commute from here, from there basically to just at about this location here, someplace to Ostrava. I am not gonna go and waste much time on this stuff. This is eventually a castle in Ostrava. Okay, so let's just go on and I'll find the location along the audio. Hi, good day to you.
Dva tisonče, 2015, to?
No. To je nové, to robí, já bych se 12, 15. To?
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. As you were able to see, I did point it out bridge outstandingly. He replied me, "Hi, how are you?" We greeted each other and I said, "Would you please tell me this, the bridge right here in front of us?" This bridge here was is the bridge that was built sometimes in either 2012 or something. This is a new bridge, and I insist on my claim, as was evident. He takes some time, and I also use the words such as this is eventually a new bridge. If you were to look,
this
one
is the bridge we're talking about, and
this is exactly the bridge, precisely the bridge. I do have a video recording of this bridge. He, the gentleman, gives me a green light. This is a Roma gentleman.
The gentleman, it's actually, thanks.
Okay, this is enough. I don't want to go on with it. I don't want to do that. You were able to see exactly who, how, more or less, enough for investigation purposes. And as we continue the conversation, I am really warm about feel really good talking to him. I will explain everything in continuation. But I also managed to point out as next his branch of work as construction, and also as him being a construction worker, obviously already for over 8 years, and you're talking about extremely diligent, hardworking construction worker, worker that would spend per day working from morning all the way through the night. He would be returning back at night time, late at night. We would be even going home at 8 or 9 o'clock at night, he and I. We would be returning home. During MK Ultra, this gentleman was simply exceptional with me. I will explain everything in continuation. Now, sometimes I would spend some time watching him and causing problems to his co-workers. And on other times they would take me to the city, mess with me somewhere in the city, whatever they were doing with me, and then they would bring me back to him. Always, however, always, that's why I said, you're going to hear me, that he's very nice, I keep repeating him. This man, regardless of how unpleasant I was, and I really was, God knows I wanted to run out of the picture. And he was just surprised with ability, with maybe even the right, I should say, to interfere deeply into my psyche. He wanted to learn maybe about me because I'm from Slovenia, I'm non-Roma, and he wanted to learn more about the people. How do I pursue the world? How do I see things? Maybe even why I was like this and that, which at the time he could not learn. But I am going to tell you something he did learn. He did learn. This is just a gentleman that was in love with me. Okay? I'm going to put it plain and simple. This is just a gentleman that just now he came to me more. He did. This guy, it wasn't only that he never ever was insulted with me. It's this man eventually that loved me to the grave. Maybe this is crazy, but he I will explain in continuation. Let's just continue. Now I know even this. I actually know the whole thing now.
Thank you.
Now, I Czech government, it provided me with the leads, just like Polish did. The people who were involved in MKUltra would appear. Most of these people, I estimate about 90% of the people were people out there that were more than willing to help. Despite my political involvement, for which I'm going to tell you all folks that I'm going to repeat the Donald Trump's words to me, because Donald Trump had idea exactly the opposite of mine. But this I learned from him, I will be honest with you. There's one thing I learned. He said, the money is not worth anything if it comes to the wrong hands. The money is not worth anything if you share one with the wrong people. And you see, why I'm doing this stuff, I'm making sure that the people who meet me, who greet me, people with whom I see myself again, have seen human being in me, obviously, as first. This is one of the things. And the second thing, which obviously is more important, number one is more important than the politics, but still the second thing is that these are not the wrong people, that this is not people that would be associated with some kind of neo-Nazi ideology that would cause a real, real problem to our environments here in Eastern Europe. These are no-nos. And for the most part, I have to say I'm pleasantly even surprised with the people. On other occasions, people already find, you know, those 10%. I would just break that down to about maybe 90% of those 10% are politically motivated people, people that see political influences more important, lobbyists basically, for the wrong, for always wrong side, because they will do this regardless of which way this would go. So not even as wrong, but just, you know, people who serve political lobby basically. But as I stated, the 90% I would estimate as great people, 10% as remaining 10 of 10% of 10% of 10% remaining 10%, I will estimate about 90% politically motivated as no kind of people. And so let's continue with this stuff, with this outstanding Roma gentleman whom I have met in Ostrava on September the 8th of 2020. He was not happy about this. Just, hello, is this bridge was built this in 2012? Please, can you tell me? Yes, it was, and thank you and goodbye. And I'm really, really glad that we did not stop just like that, briefly that day. I had a very difficult day. I will explain in continuation. Quite some time was really difficult for me, and he definitely deserved it some more than just hello and goodbye. And he let me know about this. The next thing, he wanted to get some cigarette from me or something like that, which unfortunately, as much as I would love to give him, but I don't smoke. I am a non-smoker. He says, "Na svidanya," he says, in a friendly way. We tease each other because he and I long, like I said, this was one of the nicest people you possibly could come across. And I already feel really bad at this point that I'm doing something that I basically I'm doing some kind of even favor to the politicians. You're not supposed to be like that. I said, "I'm sorry, but I'm not smoking." He asked me about the cigarettes. "Sorry," I said, "I'm not smoking. I'm just myself." I said, "I don't smoke, I'm searching for the job here," and so on. Once I mentioned the job, this is actually his field. He's like, "Aha, you will definitely remember me now, because I mentioned the job." And because of what I have already earlier stated, he used to take me at his work. And he is like, now he doesn't understand anything, basically what I'm saying, to wake me up. And I finally ask him if he's had some job. And he is like pretending that he still does not understand and does not understand anything about what praca is, nothing. What the job is, nothing in Polish, nothing. Then I have it kind of enough. I said, but you used to work in a construction. In construction, do you have in construction something? And I said to him later on, I continue just so there wouldn't be something difficult, so this is not gonna break my spine because I have a spine injury. No, he says, I said, for me, you have some job for me. And he says, he's looking at me and he says, for me, and we're joking like this. It's kind of a funny. Yeah, for you. And he said, for you? He said, yes, for me. And I finally think he already understands me, and he says, so you want me to work for you, and so on and so forth. And I said, no, I am looking for the job. And I said, I'm looking job for myself. Now he start to talk in Polish, and he says to me, how much you give me for the job? It's joking. He's really messing. And now he's asking me again, you are the one who want to work. Yeah. And he's asking me, and what do you want to work? And I know that he is working in a construction business. Budovania. No, in a Russian, that's a troika. Stroika. I don't know what even he said. I don't understand the word of what he said. But I said, in Russian is stroika. Budovanie. Stroy budovanie. Burani, these are apartments, something like this. He used to work in construction. He used to always do some kind of construction, heavy work. But I don't know how much heavy this work was. It was heavy. I remember they did for the base for these buildings and so on. And he would work, from, like I said, from early in the morning until they would have already reflectors at night, and he would still work. And boy, we would be returning home at 8-9 o'clock sometimes. I said, but what kind of job you do? What kind of job do you do? I am a mechanical engineering technician, fluent in 7 languages, can do work with the computers, customer support and stuff like this. This is not even my field, whatever. And I have never done anything like construction in my lifetime. But because of what I remember, I knew that this is the kind of job he has. And I was thinking, you know, for the beginning, just to establish myself, maybe he has something in his branch. So now he's going to tell me this is basically what he does.
Burani, but he
says this kind of construction business is tells me very difficult. You're not gonna make it basically with construction business. You're not gonna get through because I have injury. Now, does he know about my injury? Well, I'm gonna put it this way, the whole Ostrava knew it. People in United States of America knew I'm gonna have one. It went around the globe, the news, before I even suffered this injury, because of other people who have gone through and have suffered at least somewhat similar fates to mine. I said, do you remember me or not?
Memory.
Memory, I say. And he says, no. No, he is teasing me again. He is basically saying, is encouraging me, basically saying, when somebody said to you, no, it's like, I want to hear more. Come on, tell me more. Like this, basically, translated. Saying already halfway, yes, basically. But he's going to say, I don't speak English.
No,
you see, I don't understand. Then he says, I don't understand. He is a tease.
You understand. Yes, you understand.
I said, yes, you understand.
He said to me in Sweden, in Slovenian, to me, по-чешски, на Сведении. На складане, из по-чешски. До складане.
Okay. I'm not even sure Nasvidania, if this Nasvidania, this really is po slovensku. In Slovenian language is Nasvidania. I see that. I'm not even sure if he's a teaser. На свидание. Прощай. Let me see this here. He is a teaser. This is in Slovenian language, even even na Svidenje, this is in Slovenian language, right? And he's saying, no, it's in the Russian. So I think that really, really knows really, really good. I really have to see this, because I think that he actually told me in Slovenian language goodbye here. So the chances here even exist that already here. До свидания is in Russian language, and he said to me на свидания. Okay, so this guy knows I am Slovenian. Prošaj do svidanja. Do svidanja. Do svidanja, and he said to me na svidanje. Okay. Yep. There you have it. So the gentleman actually even told me in Slovenian language, in Slovenian, not in Russian, goodbye. And there is nothing in, not even another Slavic language that would be na svidanje. If it's not in Russian, there is no other. So there you have it. Listen to this.
Memory. Do you remember me? No one is there. You understand. Yes, you understand, you understand.
No, understand.
You said to me in Sweden, yeah.
In Slovenian.
I said this is the bridge we're talking about.
Na Skladane.
And the German.
Na Skladane.
actually, thanks to him, you know. It's actually thanks to him. He was the one, he gave me about the overview about this area here. Under MKUltra.
So this gentleman more than recognized me.
Yes, you understand. You said to me in the Sweden, yeah. In Slovenia.
Eventually he shows me the spine. Okay, I'm not going to be looking for Nasvidanie. This is yet another proof. The gentleman eventually did more than recognize me. He knew exactly where I am from. I cannot say nie rozumiem, nie rozumiem. Yeah, that could be nie panimaju, it would be in Russian. Nie rozumiem, this would be in a Serbo-Croat. That could be yet another clue that he is talking Slovenian language, because ne razumem is in Slovenian language. Ne razumem, that would be in Serbo-Croat language. But I think then again in no other language. And this is in a Czech Republic, and the gentleman is a Roma. So this one really, really... This is also in Czech. I cannot say that though. Okay. I tell him, and also, well, in Polish too, okay. Okay, I tell him, listen, I said, man, thank you very much. Take care of yourself. Get yourself, build yourself some home. Do something like this. And... all the best I wish you, I told him. I am already almost sure that I'm going to go apart, but since we are going, we're heading the same direction, I come to my senses, I say, well, since we're going in the same direction, and I'm very, very warm about this gentleman.
We're talking about, and the gentleman is...
And I make decision, I'm just not going to let go like that, and I... therefore, I proceed in the direction.
He gave me
in his direction, in his company. He hears me when I say this, and he becomes more interested in me. He does not want to let me just go like this. He's very social.
Was a superstar, Hollywood.
He's asking me, why do you film me?
No.
I tell him, you know what, you're gonna be a superstar in a Hollywood. He said, no. He showed me, what do you have over there. Let me see what you recorded about me. Ah, he cannot be even like this from the distance. He cannot be even seen.
No.
I show him. He says, no, me, not Hollywood superstar. Okay, I tell him, listen, it was thanks to you that I recognized the bridge. Yeah, you are the one you teach me in 2012, 2013. You were here again to meet me, to give me a confirmation about it, and I really am thankful to you. That's why I did this. You, however, you cannot be seen anywhere. I showed him the video. It's just a small picture. Nobody can really see from this anything. And so that's why I did this. And he said, really? He said, I'm the one, really? I said, I remember you. You work from the morning until late at night. You know, he did this for at least 8 years like this already. No, he does this already for 8 years. I said, do you remember how you used to work at night? He says, and how do you know about this? Now, he was thinking that I forgot about this, but this is, I could never possibly forgot. I would be going together with him in the evening time, right across this bridge we would go. And what I can say is, this is just a person who was very interested in me, in learning more about me. But what I can tell the most about this man is that he was motivated in helping me out. I know this. I know, because you can feel. Because you can feel, and there is just so much. I met his family, his mom. And this man was just, how can I say? They told him, no, he will not. He will forget us and this and that and da-da-da-da-da. And he said, it's not true. He told all of them, which they liked me. His family liked me. They all liked me. But they couldn't believe that we're going to see each other again and so on. And he told them, you know what? He said, listen to me very good. He said, this is how much he believed in me. And I was extremely, extremely dismissing to him. He said, one day, you are made, you're going to make it all this. He said, you're going to bring this, all this project about this thing that we met here and all this thing. You're going to make it, he said one day. He said, everybody was sure that I'm crazy too. Roma people were sure that I will not remember any of this anyways. There was all kinds of stuff that went on. But he said, you are going to make it this because you, and I know this, he said. You are the kind of a person, you're the kind of a people. First, what he did was he wanted to know what kind of cars I like. And back then, under MKUltra, I dreamed about Mercedes and BMWs, about the German cars. And he said, you are the kind of man who makes a BMWs and Mercedes. You are the one who make this kind of cars. He told me, do you understand this? He said, you can do this. He said, you can do this stuff. This man was in love in me, simply. And today I'm in love in him, because what I can recall how we were together bodies over there in this place, because of when we would walk back. And all I wanted to do is I wanted to run away from the picture. I want to hide myself. I couldn't. And so what I was extremely unpleasant. Even with the ladies, I became obnoxious, to be honest with you. From beginning, I would tolerate this abuse, but it was so many ladies that would do me harm. They would tease me and this and that, and it was always another man that would pop up. From the flirt, it would be something completely different. And some, they were really, really inappropriate. And in the late stages, I was just not pleasant to be around with at all. Now, I'm not going to even forget what I did once over there in Belarus during MK Ultra to my ex, which this is completely crazy stuff I did. And she didn't take it seriously, you know. She dated me later on in 2017. But I'm just saying that under MK Ultra, I was completely obnoxious, okay? In my last stages, the more it went toward end, I believed in a tactic that if I would be very, very unpleasant to people, that people would just leave me alone somehow. But that just didn't happen, all right? The politicians took it, and they took all that stuff in their advantage. So now you see that I know him very good.
Money.
He said, give me the money, okay? Now he knows that I recognize him. And we start to joke. He said, wait, you have to go to Hollywood to get the money. I said, you and I, we go to Hollywood. He said, with me, you go to Hollywood, right? I think I'm teasing him. I'm asking about the fish, and I'm trying to find out actually if he has some girlfriend. He knows that I love fishing and stuff like this, but then I twist around things in a funny way. If there is some fish and this and that, you know, a boy's talk. I tell him, you know, the kind of fish that is swimming. And the kind of wish that is walking on two legs. So we're laughing, and I think I'm not even actually sure what he might actually have already fished at home. There was something about a fish back then too, so I'm not sure at this point. I remember his mom very well. As much as we stated to each other goodbye several times, we're still going together in the same direction. talk about something about maybe even telephone or something like this, and I tell him that my light or something like this. I tell him my telephone is dead, and I still have to come to Poland. He asked me, where do you live? And I tell him in Chałupka, in Poland. I tell him I am gonna need the telephone, the light, whatever remained of battery. Now at this point I am without anything, I cannot even charge this. This coronavirus, I have no electric outlet, I'm inside of the car. Inside of the car they do something really, really bad to me. They create some kind of, again, they get inside of the car and they connect the fuses in a such a way that the rear light, which you cannot even see, is turned on, was turned on until the battery failed. It's the stuff that was happening to me at this gas station that also was bad stuff, really bad stuff, but that becomes evident later on. The cars are coming and you're walking back to Chałupki, to Poland. You need to have at least some kind of flashlight, something to alert them so they don't actually, you don't get hit by the car. And that's why I cannot, I'm trying to preserve every little of this battery, whatever is left in this telephone. I have another 15 kilometers with them before I get home tonight. On foot. I said, listen, I said, man, thank you very much. You take care of yourself. And he says, wait, he said, give me your telephone. He says, give me your telephone number, I will call you. This is really, really hard for me to be here today, rather than there. I would love to be over there in the Czech Republic. It was really a beautiful crowd that started to gather around me. It was few really, really nice people, including people on a location where I was, where they broke me the car, where they have stolen me the wallets, telephones. There were some really down-to-earth people over there, two people that were involved in 96, 97, 98 in this stuff, that were looking forward to see me, to meet me. The Ostrava, the Czech Republic, wonderful people, just like a Poland. And I think this is exactly what Mr. Andrei Babich, realized. That's exactly what they came up with, that they're going to do something horrific to me. Because Ostrava, this is like in a little finger to me. Who knows me in Ostrava? Everybody. Who doesn't? Old Bohumín, New Bohumín, Ostrava. I mean, this is the area that is like, whoa, like too easy for me to identify the whole city. And I think this is what, this is why they did something in a such a way that because I love Czech people and Polish people, and because I want this to remain in me, because the situation is so, what they did is so idiotic, so contrary to logic. You know, the individual who did this to me is an individual who actually really was discriminated against. I am certain I made him really feel uncomfortable. because it's exactly the kind of people I fight for. And it's because Roma people alone made me feel so comfortable to be around them. Nobody ever did attempted to take anything from me. I felt very good at being around them. The gentleman you I'm talking to right now eventually offered me that he would pay me for the ticket to go back to Hauptke, the Roma gentleman I'm talking to. The last thing I would make an assumption would be that somebody like this would go and steal me, which he did. It was a Czech guy who did this, who was involved in MK Ultra from 96, 97, 98. That proceeded and took from me two telephones with the SD cards, with the USBs and so on. This is something that, like I said, I'd rather not to even think about because it's impossible to explain. There is no logic in it. It's just the part that it was extremely painful for 1 month. Believe me, I was in trauma because of this stuff, because it was unexplainable. Maybe more than anything, it was unexplainable. But Andrej Babic, even more unexplainable, because the police department involved in this stuff was the police department. This Czech police was department exclusively. The people whom I know since 96, 97, was the Czech department that pledged to the residents, to the neighbors, to the people in the area, that they will never ever allow any kind of Nazism, fascism and stuff like this. This is why I'm even blown more. So this is what I'm saying, that many of these police officers in this police department are good people, but that you would come out and do something so outrageous, even for the sake of the politician, I am just buffed. It's a mystery. It's unexplainable. It's too much idiotic to waste energy, brain on it. Andrej Babic, in Slovenia, actually, there were people who gestured that they should have asked him even. It was like I was even thinking about telling him to get off the picture because of the stuff that he's about to do. But today I have to tell you, and this is concerning Slovenian people, whoever gestured me this, either was a police, Slovenian police officer, whoever was involved in MKUltra, you haven't done any job, you haven't done anything really to tell me this kind of stuff back then, that this, and then actually this stuff, something like this happens and so on. That doesn't do anything, you know. This kind of stuff, it will be better you shut up, because I can still somehow listen and hear older ladies, something that she regrets, but a man, a grown-up man, a people like this who knew, who saw it, what went on, and knew what's going to happen and so on, it does me no good. Not to me, not to you, not to anybody. Especially, I'm saying this to the police who claimed they were doing the stuff actually I'm really doing for the sake of the people and so on. I don't know what to say about that. I said, and now what I'm doing, now I'm kidding him. Now I'm joking with him. I understood, I knew that he wants my number, and now I'm telling him, give me your telephone. Come on, I said, give me your telephone. And even in Russian, I tell him, davai mi your telephone. Now, the thing is that this is very political, and he gets on the toes like a cat. It is very sensitive about this. He doesn't want to give a telephone. He doesn't even want to give me his Facebook or whatever. He doesn't want to give me any information, but he wants my telephone. He wants to keep in touch with me. This man loved me. Now I'm playing with him. I can give you a Polish telephone. The truth is, at this point in time, I still have not had a Czech number. It might have been actually the first day that I got a Czech number, and he might have been actually the first person, as you're about to hear, I had given my Czech number to. He's a little bit annoyed because I don't have a Czech number yet, and I really don't. In Czech Republic, telephone, internet are extremely, extremely expensive. 10 times more expensive than in Poland. I show him my telephone is dead. My telephone died in meanwhile. I show him it's a light here and I need it.
My mom is Polish telephone.
And I also have a Polish number on one. I don't have a Czech number yet. September 8, 2020. I show him so that he doesn't think I'm lying to him or something. I said, give me the number. He goes, It's like, no. He's very political. People are afraid. I said, Facebook. You have a Facebook? All of a sudden, he doesn't have. I said, I have a Facebook. He's like, he's not gonna be through the Facebook. I said, give me your number. He's like, no. Of course, I'm very serious that my intention was okay. I didn't have anything bad. This is really funny. I tell him I'm gonna get the Czech number. What are you so afraid of?
Okay, yeah, that is for you.
He is afraid, political. Yeah. It's a political situation, very bad. He get his some telephone ring something, his telephone, some sign he gets something.
Okay. So test it on.
I give him everything.
Facebook.
And what I did was, it was like this. How was it? The day earlier, I think. It must have been the day earlier that I bought just new Czech number. Which I did not have, I think, even 1 week or something like this. No. 5 days later, I think they have stolen me one. I did not activate the number yet. Once I give him the number, number is not activated yet. Number would be activated eventually once on the night I cross into the Czech Republic, because I'm completely without the internet and I don't know how to get to the location which I'm trying to get to the lakes, which I have designated, charted, will be my designated location. And so that happened on the 13th. On the 14th, the brand new Czech SIM card with I don't know how much money on it is already stolen along together with the telephones. So, nothing you could do possibly. But I gave him all the information, bro. I gave you all the information. Keep in touch with me. Many times we would sit like this on a bench and talk to one another. He he would be asking me, but why this, but why that, but why do you think like this and that?
Facebook, prime, a to email moi, a to tu jest numer, telefon.
I gave him the Facebook, telephones.
Uh-huh.
I didn't have. I don't have a Czech number yet at this point. I'm asking him what kind of should I buy in the Czech Republic, so the cheapest. So I gave him the Facebook, a number, Polish.
Boy,
I tell him to take a picture of the stuff too. I give him the resume from my computer. I give him the resume. I tell him, if you have a camera on your telephone, take a picture. He is even afraid to do this. This is very, very like this, you know, situation. Mr. Andrei Babic, this is just bad stuff. As soon as this case ends up, I'm looking forward big time to a Czech Republic. Czech Republic and Poland are a beautiful people to be around with. Beautiful countries and a beautiful people to be around with. Just as long as it's not something like Trump related, that kind of stuff. And these are a wonderful countries, a wonderful people to be around with. I'm looking forward to spend some time, if not life, in Czech Republic and in Poland. Or I should say in Poland and in Czech Republic and so on.
І файні єси чоловік, ти єси працювати, і добрий чоловік єси, добре серце мовське.
You are a hard working man, you have a good heart, I told him, you are a nice man. Really.
Єси такий мирний нормальний.
And he was always very tranquil, this guy. This guy was so tranquil, yeah. The stuff the politicians cooked, you would think that in respect to the Roma people, because I had experience with the Polish people that would do all kinds of stuff like that, and I don't even blame them in many circumstances.
Okay.
They would never greet me, they would never want to have anything to do with it. The thing about it is they came to me. With open hands, more often than not, and if not, still, they would welcome me to their hearts, either way. Their hearts were always open to me. I'm trying to make him photo of my resume so he can always contact me, so he has all the information about me. I write him down, everything he says. I do. He is afraid, really afraid. And at this point in time, I have to say, I am really, really sorry. I have not stayed in a Czech Republic. Really, really sorry about it.
Я ти напишем тебе. Давай, я ти напишу. І не бенджи зроби то. Там я юж маш буем.
The plan was to get the job, to make some money in Czech Republic and go back to Lodz, basically. No, this was the original plan.
А то важно є. Айде, давай. Айде, добро. Okay. Oh. Так. То дашу комп'ютер і добиш всичко тотло. Всичко одне робиш, всичко інформацію. Це моє резюме. Ну, це ви.
А тарі?
Та, що?
Кола?
А?
Я ж кола тарі. Кола комп'ютер.
Ну, там не правий. Scuola, no? No.
At this point in time, we're located here someplace.
Scuola? Scuola?
No, there's half. No, так, я школа вам. Дай зроб одну збільшу там на телефону, дай
по
на шибку, а дай
так. То не мій.
Не твій телефон.
He says it's not his telephone and stuff like that, okay.
Хайда, тримайся то.
Тримайся.
І добре є, що шовик. Нормальний є, що дуже нормальний шовик є.
We do hug each other, I hug him. I don't let him go, I really want to hug him, eh? I... I tell him you're very normal, the wolf. Many people that were just completely messed up, they didn't know, they behave completely out of context and stuff, and you never did, you were always calm, nice. And he says, yes, always nice and very calm and everything, but the money, there is no money, you see. I tell him, yeah, I said, this is how it is, this is what life is like.
No.
It's actually right now when I listen to this very hard to me here. He's disappointed because I don't have a Czech telephone. I told him not yet. It's too much money for me. You know what? I tell him about the telephone, how expensive it is. I said, where are you going now? I said, I go back to Poland on foot, and then tomorrow I come back to look for the job. And he says, you know what? He says, I'm going to give you the money for the trip. I'm going to pay you for the bus ticket. I tell him, no, you don't have to. I don't need. I like to walk. No, this is a little sweet bro. This is what this is. No, this is what this is. Now you have it. That's why it's very difficult for me to even to listen to this. he's asking me now if I have a BMW or Mercedes already. And I said, if I have a BMW or Mercedes, I said, no, I don't have, but you have it. And you're going to have it, I tell you. The issue behind Mercedes BMW I already have explained. So I think that the gentleman more than just recognized me. I definitely consider this that he recognized me. I know about him. I pointed out facts. No, he did as much as he possibly could, and it's not difficult to realize that he was very much afraid of the political something that could happen. No, I don't blame him. It's very difficult for the Roma people. Let me explain something how miraculously this thing was. All right, what happened exactly that day? That day is the day I spent time right here in Ostrava, right? And then I decided to make a plan for the next day that would somewhat give me chance to see the potential job area where I was not yet. Because I did go through the Ostrava back and forth already in, well, considerable amount of employers I already visited. However, I had a plan to go specifically through this area, and in fact I was preparing myself for something that would give me a chance that I would not have to go to the bus, and that I would not have to commute myself on foot back all the way to Hauptki, to Poland. It was taking humongous toll on me, walking back like this for 15, sometimes even 20 kilometers. So the plan was really, really easy. Even if I had to, it would be a sacrifice that would go on, probably a little struggle for about maybe a month, even maybe two. I love the outdoors, so I started to contemplate on a possible lake in a vicinity here where I would go and just set the camp. And for that matter, I wanted to go through this industrial area, which I did here, to see, to get an idea what exactly that looks like. All right. And that day, it seems like everything was about the Roma people anyhow. First, right here in this area, there was a gentleman right at this bridge here that you see. That's not the gentleman right you see right there, but it was another gentleman who parked his vehicle here, and whom I have also recognized. For that matter, I have saved another audio recording, which would be this one here, also recorded on the same day, September 8th of 2020. Who would not give me a confirmation, he somehow would not give me a green light about three existing barracks right here that you see right in front of you. And this is just a few meters away from Ostrava. There is a Ostrava, Ostravica river right here. And another three barracks, Roma barracks, that were exactly here somewhere, something like this. He would not give me the green light that in 96, 100% in 96, the three barracks like this in fact existed right here. He would just not give me 96, even 97, he would not give me this green light. The gentleman I was talking to, and the one I'm referring to, eventually became wealthy through what I believe was either some sort of business in a vicinity here. I would actually even have to go and see. Or maybe even a construction, on an apartment building or something like this. He would take a loan, get in touch. Well, actually, to put it plain and simple, straight through Donald Trump's connections. Being around me, he had found himself in the right circle of people that would make him things like this eventually possible. So he, to me, was of no point. He was to me of no, he didn't make me know. It was, how can I say? It was a Donald Trump's way, all right? Maybe I'm guilty because I didn't ask him if he had a business over there or whatever, but for me it was of a paramount importance, a fact of the matter that Roma people were actually right here. And because of Donald Trump's picture he was involved with, because Donald Trump demanded from the local authorities, actually even challenged them, bullied them on how they can have a Roma people next to the beautiful river like this, prime real estate, and I don't know what he involved, so he get them out of the area. This is the racist Donald Trump. This is what he did, actually. This kind of stuff he did. He just wrecked them, basically, just because they were Roma people, basically, just like this. I did not even bother to ask him who he is, what he is, whatever he is. I just went my way. He would not give me a green light on that. And he was here. He knows about this. Yeah, some of these people were actually even ashamed that the Roma people were here. And I was actually kind of ashamed to even talk to the guy like this. So what I did was I just proceeded my way. Simple as this. As I would cross the river, there was more waiting on me, right there and right then. It was just more. It was just a day, a Roma day. It was just a day that was waiting for me, that I have to say, as soon as I proceeded on the other side of the river, I recognized a settlement of the Roma people on the other side of the river. Just on the other side of the river, right here, there would be one even cement block structure from Roma people, which was then demolished away. There were houses here. There was like a housing area here for the Roma people. There were quite a little settlement right here on this side and a settlement on this side. And through my videos, which I have, in fact, recorded that day, eventually, I even point out, trying to understand, eventually even point out where their settlement was, where these
this
houses
was a,
were.
This Roma settlement here.
Here we are, look.
Okay. What you see over there, this, they had homes here, all over, on both sides of this road, here and there. But it was just exactly as I explained. And Donald Trump, I will not forget that. There was a road over there.
Yes, they built this road. This is the road they built. The road you see here, according to MK Ultra memory.
And Donald Trump.
This came up to life. I probably estimate sometimes, I don't know, maybe in 2000, something like this. And the racism, discrimination against the Roma people. Well, when you go to the place like this, ladies and gentlemen, the memories of the past, after I was drugged up, just float, and you feel like you have people right next to you. You can see them talk, like you go back in time, and eventually you could see them talk to one another. And I will not forget Donald Trump.
I will not forget that there was a road over there. claimed
construction.
That they had the best piece of the real estate.
Yeah, on this.
Because the river is actually just here nearby.
On this side of the river, he
so
did the same thing.
This is what this was, and checks were really.
No, this is not explained well. If you would be here, you would hear the traffic, you would hear the cars, a pollution, all kinds of stuff. Yet Donald Trump was just miserable. How can I say? He would be disturbed. He would be bothered even with the fact that they have no place to go and they live in close to impossible circumstances. He would completely disregard and he would just want them to be displaced away from here. Even this is the stuff that bothered him, because this tool on the other side of the river was close to the river. This is insane. I will not forget that stuff. Let me see what this is. That was a little bit wrong player I have used right now, but now it's going to take too long, really too long. This was the day when I have identified many, many, many bridges. Many, many bridges throughout Ostrava. And got confirmations for some,
Of the two bridges, this is yet another bridge that went down. Of the two bridges, the one that went down over there in that direction where I indicated, and this one, this was the one that went down immediately. This one went down already in 96. That one, in the best case scenario, at the beginning of my work at Wackenhut in 99. That's like the longest that it could last.
This was the day for me to identify bridges, ladies and gentlemen. I go all the way to, as you have heard, 96, 99, and stuff like that. So the bridge I have identified, thank you to the gentleman right here, to a Roma gentleman from 2012, 2013, with such a precision all the way to 2012, 2013. So now you can see that my memory has a capacity to determine time anywhere from year 1995 and all the way to 2013, 2013, 2012 with 100% certainty. I mean, this is actually, I have to say, amazing. But it is, as I stated, it is because I have done a lot. And I, over time, you start to become better and better in estimating the time and so on. You know, I want to see the other bridge. This is what I practically I was. This one went down in year 99.
Don't get me wrong, that bridge always was there. But this here was for the pedestrians, I think. This bridge was still in 96, 97. But I doubt that the bridge survived to 98. Because it did a thorough reconstruction of this whole place. The whole place, big time. 98 probably is when the bridge
was gone. 99 was still there. Because I was at Wackenhut, I got that 99 job. So that's why I know.
And that's the trail I was just at.
But that it didn't come to me immediately, but
this was for the pedestrians.
It was
that
still
bridge,
99.
However, always was there. Just, I don't think it was that wide, whatever. They modernized one.
They modernized one, they did. Folks, this is the stuff that what you have seen actually was recorded, I think, and I'm pretty damn sure that must have been then in that case it should be here, but I don't see the it must have been here actually, right? I think it must have been here. This here, just that you cannot see from the top, but there is a water like this. There is something like that. Not an easy thing to just go and spot, for one thing. But the way I do this stuff, the way I did this stuff, actually, let me see this here. I would say that it's got to be somewhere here, like this. stuff. This pretty much is exactly what I was doing on that day. And so this is the day I dedicated to redefining the greater area of Ostrava and the greater area of Ostrava, which it was the Roma people that made my day. The Roma community made my day as I would go through these settlements and find these settlements. Eventually here on this side, this is very important for me. Very, very important. And this is really all thanks to Roma people. On this side, I have pointed out, and I'm not completely sure whether this could be the video, maybe. I don't know. I have pointed out exactly where the house cement building structure from Roma people was. That kind of stuff is what I am talking about. So this was definitely the thing to do. Now, look at this.
Eventually, I was told one of the versions that here, on this side, and this end, basically.
Yes, yes.
There was a adjustment to the rail. Now I see that thing right there.
No. This, you would have to be from here to know to do something like I have done it right now. There was a rail adjustment. You would have to spend some life here and get old in Ostrava that you would have the information like I have supplied you with right now. The MK Ultra staff members is what I am talking about that would be coming. The included psychologists and from Norway and psychologists from all over the place that also was non-psychologists but economically involved people like that would come. They would have a hard time doing the stuff, memorize the stuff I did, and they alone would face crisis now in respect to the issues I am explaining and issues I have explained, basically determined on my on the videos I have gathered that day. This is undeniable fact. On this portion of the rail, there was adjustment, but you have to go. Okay, there is other parts like here that you see, not precisely this here, but there are like other parts of the rail here. I think that this is what it was on the other side that you could see, but the rail never went over there. If you would not know the stuff from so long ago, you would never point it out that in here, on this portion of the rail, right here that you see the rail, that was like a little deviation, adjustment of the rail. This is elevated. The only way you would know the stuff I am talking about is that you would eventually be here in year 96, 97, 98. Otherwise, you would never ever know the stuff I am talking about. Because at the lower portion of the rail, actually this here, nothing was adjusted. This thing here would only stay clear to Donald Trump at later stages. All other people, eventually they have even forgotten. And look at it. Look at it. Look at it. Look at it. I think that right here, this thing that you see here, this white thing, I think this is the some kind of adjustment that might have actually suggest the remnants of the old rail location in that sense, or something like this. It could be that this is what it was or something. I have no clue. This here. So this is as much as the rail was adjusted. They did adjust the rail. They widened this thing and they have done something to it. I have no idea what went on. But what I stated only to Donald Trump would remain evident. Donald Trump did go through here several times. I guess not everything was in vain for nothing to be around Donald Trump. this was the day.
If I properly remember this stuff, there was some kind of a house here too, I think.
Yes, it
was.
There
was something here, or actually this was quite big here.
Yeah.
There was something here.
The last one that was
something
gone
was here.
Was right this one.
Definitely
here.
Something was here, I remember. This was the thing that went down the last.
No, not quite, but it was like this. To be with a precision, with like precision of eagle. The first that went down was this here that you see on this side. The second that was down was not this here. This, it was another little house here. Wooden chalet, whatever the Roma people had. But, excuse me, the second that went down was this here. Okay, so one more time. Number one, this area. Number two, this area. And number three, we have still found Roma people hiding here. There is a possibility those, however, returned back and restarted their little settlements. So, yeah, I mean, me being here since 96, a fact undeniable.
Now, what exactly was this thing here?
Would Roma people remember me? Very good, they remember me.
1996, this thing here.
Oh, 97 too, and 98.
What was here? What was here? What something?
Eventually, it came out clear, if it was not a lie, that the Roma people, they resettled them to a better location, that they did got them some kind of apartment or something, and that this is what I sincerely also hope for, that they did took care of them. But I think it was very difficult to face somebody like Donald Trump, what went on. Tough stuff.
This here also was something, but went down earlier. This I do not know, but they told me that this has something to do with some kind of what is not true. It can be true. It's not. I have no idea what this would be. No, I was told this has something to do with some kind of overpass across and stuff like this, but I doubt it. I doubt it. I have no idea. Another building structure here.
I have identified other
and
structures along
this building
the way.
Structure. Something else here.
It was, no.
I doubt it. I doubt it. I have no idea what this.
This is me identifying.
What this would be here, I do not know.
That
frankly,
same
I don't
day,
know.
This
but
area right here, along the rail.
There is something else here.
I reminded myself of other buildings here too.
I believe there was another building structure here.
Not that I believe. This was a structure that was here in 1996. 1995 and 1996. And probably went down, I don't know, my God, in 97 or something like this.
And this building structure, I believe, was behind this thing here.
Eventually, I would go, as I would walk like this, along this trail, and the only thing I would do is, it would not come to me clear immediately. You cannot see anything because the grass is, it's a tall grass. If you would just go and you would walk here along this path here, you could just walk and know nothing. But eventually what happened was, my memory was preserved well enough for me to eventually go and spot in a grass, out of grass, already wood. It was good enough for me to point out what buildings were there still in 95, 96 and so on. I did so too.
So we're talking about three building structures, basically one here and two over there, up there. This is a year 1996.
Yeah, look at look what this is.
Most
like.
Of this did not even survive to 1997, I think.
Yeah. this was
wait a minute,
a place
there is
too.
Something here that I can still access, that I can still
you
see.
You will not have a clue that the building was
that
here.
That I can still see.
You see what this is? No way. Trees.
It might be.
They dumped the stuff here and so on.
There is just some stuff that is dumped over there. Let me see this. There is stones here.
Stones.
There is stones here. There
base.
Is stones here.
Base of the building.
This is a firm ground. This is a firm ground. This was the building.
There
here was
go.
The building. This here was the building. It's exactly as I stated. I won. And this is yet another part of the city that I uncovered. 100% butt naked MK Ultra. The stuff that MK Ultra members would forget sometimes by 2003, 2004.
They would not know anymore. They would bring them back, like Elon Musk, like these people, these geniuses. And they would walk along this stuff with us. They would return to Ostrava here and there. And these business people would walk along, and I would be along them, and they would discuss if do you remember this, do you remember that. Do it. These people no longer would know really what went on. And they saw it with their own eyes.
How many would even remember the stuff I'm talking about
it's
now?
It's now 2020 when I did this. This was a month
I'm
and
talking
half ago,
about basically. 24 years later.
So,
and I know that
so
what I'm talking about are plain facts.
Right here, this is the path that you see. This is the way it looks like. This is what it looks like. It's not what you think, like from aerial maps, stuff like this.
You know that building up there? There were two buildings up there, the
there
second
buildings,
one.
There were buildings there too. There was...
Actually,
there was
and I'm trying to pull the... No idea, because they also lied to me. They lied to me that there was a path through the forest.
There was all kinds of stuff. Americans would have here the camp and stuff like this that you would go on. Let me see some other stuff here. Well, you know, let's see that. I was here, as I stated, something. Oh, you have not seen that. You have not seen that yet.
This is where Donald Trump would come.
This is what Donald Trump would come, yes. At the end of this trail, this is what that day was all about. This is how far I came. I eventually would find myself right here. Just like this. And I would find myself, in fact, right in front of this gas station, right in front of this fuel station. And that's from beginnings. What you see here, nothing was as you see here. The way this here, this thing was, it was, I don't even know what the hell this was. What was this thing? This was some kind of factory. Now, what kind of factory this was, I have no idea. What I can tell you is that Donald Trump told me that cement processing facility located in old Bohumians. This is, as you have seen, right along the Polish border, no longer will operate. And I already have explained that that facility, in fact, already was closed one time. I have already explained. All through, this is quite interesting. Oh my God. There you go. Beautiful. All through, you can see here, this thing still is open on Google. This thing closed down in year 97, if not even 96. A few years later, they reopened one. But Donald Trump, who would come here to this place here. I have no idea what's going on with this stuff now. You see this stuff here? You see this stuff here? This wheels in the top. This kind of stuff. This is exactly what this place used to look like. There was just much smaller wheel. There was none of this round things that you see here. None of this round stuff. There was none of this stuff. It would be just like you see here, this wheel, this things right here that you see on the top. That's the way it was from the beginning here too. And this thing was taken away, it was gone, and Donald Trump told me sometimes in, I suppose sometimes in 99 or something like this, that this is the new facility, this is where this is going to be. And that one is finished, it's gone. And so the front entrance here that you see here, there was no fuel station. The fuel station never was here. This fuel station appeared here sometimes in the late stage. I would estimate as a fuel station to pop up here. Yeah, I have not even a clue when the hell this popped up here. This thing here. This was all other company. This entrance here was changed. I estimate this was completely remodeled that you see here up front. Let me see something else here. I need to see it. Okay. I wonder if I'm gonna have the ability to see this here. Okay, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Beautiful. What you see here is actually I estimate known as the old entrances. The two old entrances you see right there, this is old entrance, right? But what you see here on this side, if you can see it, now that's a good question whether we can see this or not. This, let me see this a little bit better. Let me see this again. I am a little bit mistaken here. Yeah, I am mistaken here. Let me see this. Yeah, I am mistaken here. This I am a little bit mistaken here. This whole thing, if I properly recall this, what the hell was here in this building? This was a completely other business. This was one facility, the whole thing. Let me just think about one business, one company, and they then talked about splitting even the company. They talked about something like, let me see this, even they talked about something keeping on this side, something like this, and I don't know what they talked about, and doing something completely different on this side. What you see here, this thing here, this modernization here, and I think it was complete restructuring of the industry, in fact. This thing that you see here appeared really sometimes. This company, everything started to change sometimes in, I estimate, 98. The first thing that changed here at this entrance, if I would be completely, completely exact about this, yeah, this is the stuff you gotta really, really know, otherwise you cannot do something like this. The first thing that was restructured here at this location here, I wanna do this really with a precision. Let me see this again here. This here, this is new, this is all new, this, but now the building is old, but this here, this is completely different. This is, I'm gonna say this is new in comparison to what it was this is new. This is a funny thing. This is something really, really funny about it. And I'm trying to establish whether it was this here first or this here first. It's not easy, as you would say. Most logically, it could be this, and then it was this, and so on and so forth. No, it did not work like this. In many, many occasions, this is not the way it was. And just, you have to pay extreme memory to get this detail. All right. I'm not going to go and rack myself down with this stuff just right now. But let me just see this stuff here one more time. I would just get to see it from here one more time. Yes. Okay. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, this is crazy stuff. As crazy it may sound, I'm going to make a claim that the first thing in this place was this here. This was the number one. And then they would put this stuff here. Okay. So this is a little bit, what you would say, probably awkward, and that's exactly why I take extra time. You understand? This is how sensitive, this is how counter assumption productive the stuff can be. All right, so this is how difficult this stuff is. Not easy at all. This number one, and this here eventually number two. The gas station here, I have no idea what, 2000 and God knows what, 2003 maybe, yes, maybe 2003, let me think about, the time runs around, spins around, and I give you 2003, goodbye, I don't have a time for it anyways. Let me do one more thing like this. This was, I have no idea what kind of company before here. It was something else. They would just go and they would just take this state-owned properties and they would just turn them private. Meaning that what you see here went private probably sometimes, I estimate, like I said, 98 or something like this is when the changes will start to appear here. You know, this is basically how that goes. This is, the workers here, they would not forgive me. They would right now run to me right here to this room, forget about Slovenia, inside of this room, and they would beat me up right now. Oh my God, how would they would get pissed off with me right now if I would just go like that. Don't forget what this stuff that you see here, this whatever the hell this is, this bombs or whatever it is, but this metal structure, something in that sense, it was remodeled as the last here, something like this. My God, this is not, this is what was confusing. This is, holy crap, this is what was confusing. Okay, this here, simultaneously, the same time, this structure, all this was here. Okay, don't beat me up right now. This also was here, but what you see here, underneath, they modernized this metal stuff here as the second. Okay, so this always was like this, this also was like this, but the metal, the stairs and all these things, and I don't know, these bombs or whatever it is, this is the stuff that was modernized, right? I don't want to get bitten up by the workers here who invested a good amount of time in helping me out. Let me see what else is here new. We can see some more stuff. You see, the more stuff I'm going to spend around here, the more precision details I'm going to be able to pull out. Okay. I see. All right, there is more to it, I think, at least. Let me see. Let me zoom myself out. Yeah, well, you know, this is nothing MK Ultra that what you possibly could imagine, and many people who would pray that I would get some kind of amnesia, memory setback or something like this, they can also go like this under their nose, because this is just not the case with me. All right, this is the company, right? Tickety tick. These are the gates of heaven for me. And I'm going to tell you about them like this. Let me just see this with a little closer, a little bit more precision, this stuff here. Oh boy, I was going to make another claim about this stuff here, but I am not completely sure enough about it. I'm not going to go into it. Eventually, that I am going to make one. I eventually am gonna take shot. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go ahead and let me think about that stuff. I don't know what exactly, what the hell, what was here and this and that. This road here that you see, yeah, I don't know how much this does have sense or not to even get into it. But according to my memory, or maybe confusion, this I'm not 100% sure. But in 1996, oh, you're talking about 1996, the property here was, trying to understand what if this thing does make sense. Something here had happened too. Something had to do with, and I'm trying to point out where we're not going to go into that. We're going to leave that out. That's all I got to say about this. I would have to spend more time. I'm not going to go into the stuff like this. Is there like anything else here that I would miss?
In 97 and 98, this was a 96. This is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful lake over there.
Okay, now this is a Donald Trump. This is definitely a Donald Trump's theory. Let me see this one more time.
In 97 and 98, this was a 96. This is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful lake over there.
Let me hear
beautiful
this.
Lake. One was like really like a clear, clear, clear lake. And then it was another lake that was not clear, that was like so, but one was really a lake, you could, natural lake. No, there is not even a trace of the lake, and I knew it, there is a lake in there. I knew it.
Okay, I don't want to call myself insane right now, especially because of the map I have seen, and the brainwash was
off. Okay, this thing here, this
like
structure
this.
Is like this. Along this road, and that's a railway right there that goes like this, and another one. I think that this is because the mistake they have made this trail. And he goes, they talked about ink, but how would this serve the floods? What this I have
they
to
talk
about
something
this.
About the floods that time also that they put the structures next to the rail that has something to do with the floods, whatever. What the hell would that have to do with the floods? I do not know. That knot, let me see this stuff here, this is important, this knot, Let me see that.
This is filmed in Ostrava. This is on.
Oh, yes.
This is on September 8, 2022. This here, this was like a little settlement here. Mm-hmm. I am not kidding. This is a rail here now. They moved these people away from here. I'm not really sure, but I think it was the Roma people that were here. But this
is just as I came, you know, just as I came across the bridge right here. So this was the day to discover the bridges where the Roma settlements were. And in the end of the day, I was really, really awarded by the Roma Friend alone. This is where I am at right now, doing this. This is just when I came across the bridge.
Here, this is a whole settlement. Yeah, this was like a little city here. But this goes back to 96, 97.
The house, the only house, one house.
I don't know.
One house was.
Is this like a remnant of the house, like a fundament? It is.
With
actually,
a base,
look.
With a stone base.
It is.
It is.
Stones.
Eventually is. There was just one.
And on the other side of the bridge.
Hey, the rail attendants. They would have like a rail attendance here too. Okay, it was like, let me think about this stuff here. Oh yeah. Okay, there is much more to it. All right, I did not explain everything the way I should have. This here was greatly remodeled to the rail. Okay, I reserved it for this time. And there was like a guard check here too. They would have rail here on duty. Now wait a minute, maybe still is, right? Or not. I'm not certain. Let me see this. Yeah, it was like a little barrack here they would have for the special detail, I think, when they were building this rail. And whenever I would come here, when the Roma people already would be gone. They would still be like, let's go and let's see this to see what you remember. The Czech people would take me and they alone would tell me what was here and what was there. And I remember they told me there was only one building that was cement built building. Everything else was just like this from them. That's how I
with the gentleman I have just spoken with have denied is not true. There were barracks too, and there were about 2-3 Roma guys that used to live there.
This is what I already have explained.
Yeah, it kind of looks crazy that I'm looking for remnants of the buildings here, right? Well, there were structures here, and it can be seen that.
No, there was
there
just
go.
One structure according
seen,
to the rail attendants. Who
it
were,
can be
who
seen
there.
Stones that there was here.
One.
Something.
That's what I believe also.
Whatever they had.
One was.
Now I would have to speak to
one
someone
cement
for
the
matter that would know back
block,
to
but
24 years ago in time.
Okay.
But this is what it is. This is filmed in Australia again. It looks like nothing, right? But it was. Here it was, and on the other side of the bridge it was. He does not even know, and this is an older person, and he does not know shit.
Excuse me, or does not want to know.
There were 2-3 Roma guys that would have like a barrack, and the barrack was on the riverside.
Five barracks
which
minimum.
Was like,
which was like
completely falling apart, spider. Barracks.
Which was like, for Americans, it was like immediately it sounded alarm to them. How did they let?
You know where they resettled those Roma people. These Roma people, they resettled them in this direction somewhere, something like this somewhere, Kunčice or something like that, in that direction. I have no idea where they resettled them, but they did, and they got them apartment. But they told me it's very far, that it was very, very far. I don't know how far. So I don't know. I don't remember. They gave them some kind of apartment. Or
them just
like
be like this. Oh, look at that. There is something here too.
But better conditions when compared
to this.
There is
that actually. That's a brick. Let me see. That's a brick. That's a brick right there. It was like alarm. How did they let them be like this in a location like that, next to the
river
and so on and so forth? It was like this. Just the man does not remember shit. This is what it is. And he was involved in MK Ultra, and he should give, I think, owner of the business just about maybe 200-300 meters away, something like this, some kind of business, something like this, something in that sense.
In that area, the man that I have spoken about, the man I have met on the other side of the river next to that bridge. So this was the day for me to discover, the day I have spent all the stuff that I have stated. It's everything is audio recording with a second audio recording device, whatever I have in fact filmed parallel also was recorded. This is something else. What I can tell you about the Roma community, I hope you didn't get tired, is that they have exceptionally well received me despite everything I have caused. Hopefully I will get across the audio recording from a family, actually very dear family to me. They felt very uncomfortable about it, but that's okay too. I was very uncomfortable too. We were all very uncomfortable, and the more that we people are uncomfortable, the more we fear, because we the people are the same, and we the people fear of what we don't know. And the politicians know how to use the stuff like this at their advantage. It was a Roma family right here from Novi Bohumin. Whose father, who is head of the family, got hurt very badly in this MKUltra process. Yet they would receive me after so many years and invite me inside. And that was a quite exciting meeting after so many years too. I was looking forward to it. Then I have another beautiful experience right here from Lodz with the Roma people. Right along this, shopping mall they built here, which is IKEA. This is yet another Roma family, bigger family, that would waste no time to meet me too. They hosted me there. Their children played with me, and mom, the Roma mom, prepared some good food. How can I say? This is, let me see if I can see them here. I cannot see any of their cars, but the owners of all this place here, all this I have identified, including the Roma people who would lodge here for many, many, many years, because the owner of the fuel station would allow them to be here, because they were exceptionally nice people. they hosted me here. They gave me food and stuff like this. These people, the Roma people, I am extremely grateful to them for receiving me like this nicely everywhere in Poland and in Czech Republic. I don't have anything bad to say. I just want to thank them for their hospitality, friendliness, kindness, and for being normal, which, believe me, the stuff I have gone through and seen, something like this, people have not seen yet. All right, today is special thank you to my friend, Roma friend. That really, really meant to me tremendously a lot that he met me on that day. That he would come, that he would appear. Sorry, this video here somehow doesn't open, but it was quite a few like this that somehow would not come to life afterwards.
So this is the bridge we're talking about. And the gentleman, it's actually thanks to him, you know.
He is perfect for the Hollywood. That's all I want to say. Thanks for watching this video. What I'm going to do it at the end, I'm going to attach this audio, or even better, I'm going to put this in a separate video, so it's not going to interfere with this, because this thing here already it's quite damn long too, and I do want to put this online. So this is yet another proof about MKUltra, me identifying greater area of in Czech Republic of Ostrava, along the Roma community, which I very much remember. And here is the gentleman I have recognized, and the gentleman obviously that recognized me. All right, so that's all. Thanks for watching. This was recorded again in Ostrava on September 8th of 2020.